I've been walking up on it. The people you are hanging out with are not your friends. I want you to ask yourself this question. Are they raising you up or pushing you down?
So, hello ladies and gentlemen, viewers. I'm very, very happy once again today to present you the Broadcasting English Club Show. That's a new show in Bandung Town, which we're going to talk about some important things. Dear viewers, I know that you are many at home watching me for a moment, and today I'm not alone. Today I'm with my brothers, to whom we are going to talk about a good topic. So it is so interesting. We are going to talk about the impact of social network as far as education is concerned. So it's a good topic that we are going to share ideas and know exactly what's the importance of the social network and in which way can we use the social network in our lives, in today's life. So I think that I'm not alone. I'm with my brothers, to whom I say good evening. So in my right I have two brothers, in my left I have one brother. So I don't know if they can introduce themselves. We're gonna know their names and their position to be very, very good. So we start with our brothers or their over there. So you may first introduce yourself, tell the people who is watching us for a moment exactly about your position or your name.
Thanks a lot. My name is Tezor Dimonja, but people often call me by the nickname Master D. I am a senior English educator and a political activist.
Okay, so thank you very much. It's my brother over here. So what's your name?
Yes, my name is Majinal Kamusama, but people used to call me Mr. Shakes. That's what I have to say for the moment.
Okay, but you are also an English speaker. So
yes, I'm also an English speaker. I learned English at the University College.
Okay, and I'm also my smart guy over here, so you must introduce yourself and tell the people who's watching for you about your name and about what you're doing.
Hi, I'm Kiyo Malika. People used to call me Hardstone. Felt like I'm wasting like a bee. So my name, so I'm a student at Uni One. I'm doing English and Business and Computer Science. So for the moment, for this lockdown, I'm in unemployment, so I'm at home.
Okay, so that's good. So I think that you understand who they are exactly, and with them we're going to talk about that topic. As I began to say, so soon we are going to talk about the impact of social network as far as education is concerned, dear viewers. So let me start with Tezor Dimonja. Yes, Master D. So today you are an English speaker, you are an English teacher, you are also an English educator. So can you tell us a few things about the education? What can we understand about education?
So education is the key for progress, development. It is, I used to call education the equalizer of human race. Okay? You can be born in a poor family, but with a good education, you can be someone, become someone in society. Okay? That's why what I can say, education is the first key of development. Okay? That's why I can say for a time.
Okay, so thank you very much. That's according to you, that definition, so you can understand according to you. So my brothers over here, you've got the same question. So can you specialize, or can you tell us a few words about education? What can we understand about education?
Yes, as Master D have just said, you know, education is something much more important for the society, because when people are educated, they can be valuable in the society, you know. But when they are not educated, I think they will be unable to do many things. So it can block the life. That's why I say education is something much more important that all people should care about. You know, that's what I have to say.
Okay, so my brothers, I think that we already gave some definition according to education. So today we are going to talk about that topic. Don't you know the title exactly? The topic is according to the social network, the impact of social network. So Today, according to your point of view, what can we understand about the social networks?
Yeah, thank you for that so important question. You know, social network is an opportunity that is given to us by technology and computer science to make people share, to be connected, you know, and make a community according to what they think is good or bad. You know, for example, today we have Facebook, we have Twitter, we have Instagram, we have WhatsApp, we have even YouTube. You see, those are all social media places where people can connect, can be together, and share more about what they think is good. That's what I understand about social media.
So that's your point of view. So let me now come back to my friend over here. So what can we understand about social network according to you?
Okay, so according to me, I see that the social network is for me a new smart world, you know, where people are sharing ideas, you know, and they are living together. And social network is a new smart world. A new smart world which brings the world like a village, you know, and even if we are far, but we are together and we are near by using social networks. So that is my point of view about what we call social network. Thank you.
Okay, so I cannot say much words about that. So Master D, you can have some words about that same question.
Yes, I think Mr. Shakes and Mr. Axel, they have already given the kind of the social networks and social media. Yeah, Shakes have said that it is an opportunity, and informatics, yeah, computer science opportunity, a platform, a website where people connect to share, okay, about what they consider good or bad. Okay, to keep in touch, That's why they call it social. Yeah, because we have to keep in touch, keep relationship, yeah, keep sharing, as we have to share in daily life. And Manika, as you say, it has another important thing to say that it is a new small world. It is a new small world that connects everybody. Yeah, more than 5 billion of people all around the world are connected via social media. Yeah, Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, YouTube, and others. Okay, that's what we can understand about social networks.
Okay, so when if I understand you by your speech or by saying words, you see that social network is what I call it. What you begin to say that we have some idea about it, will come with you. So. Today when we are talking about social network, the impact of social network as far as education is concerned, so do you think that today, if we make comparison according to the last educations and today's educations, do you think that social network are bad things or bad things?
So actually I cannot speak widely at this.
Yeah.
I want to try to pinpoint but our local situation, okay, especially our country, the RCO, our town, Bandung, okay. So the question is to know whether
whether
brought good things or bad things,
yeah,
into our today's education. So we can I can't blame social media. Yeah, I can't blame social networks because Facebook, WhatsApp, YouTube, those companies doesn't publish content. It is the users who publish content. Okay? So if the situation is so, we cannot blame them. We can blame people who are publishing and people who are using. Yeah, the users make the problems that here. In Bandung, for example, people, especially students and pupils, don't really catch or understand the importance of forest or social networks. How they use it? They use it to keep touch, to talk, okay? And even the way they are talking, the way they are writing the message, most of the time is wrong because they are using more abbreviations, yeah, instead of writing the language correctly, okay? And the topic they are debating or they are interested in are not very, very educational, okay? It is just more for entertainment or something like that. That's what we see in our daily life. That's what I can say about Trump. So, as we spend much time in entertainment topics, okay? So, their education levels decrease. Okay, students go ahead, but we are going backwards. That's the situation we are living in.
Okay, but if you say my problem is about the comparison, to make comparison between the last education and today's education regarding social network. So you mean that the today's education is wrong than the last one?
Yes.
I understand.
Yes, you're talking about the past and the present.
Yeah.
The past is was better than the present.
Yeah.
Our father. We have some teachers or some clerks in public management who are what they call D4 work living in the fourth level, okay, of the high school. You see? But they are good professional workers. Okay? They know how to write, they know how to solve problems, okay, in companies and other stuff. But today, the present tense, we have graduates, we have undergraduates, okay?
Yes, I think that we want to use sooner or later. Okay, let me later on
the level is very low.
So okay, so thank you. I got you. Right, like what you say, but I don't want to be like okay? So, but I catch what you say. So my brother over here, so you have listened to what Mostadi said.
Yeah.
So can you give us some advantages about the social network?
Yes, as you know, as everybody knows, the social media has got many advantages. We just don't have to just talk about the negative ways of seeing the social media. We just also have to talk about the advantages. I say the first advantages and the many advantages of social media is connectivity. You know, social media today has given us the opportunity to meet people from all around the world. You see, no matter how far you are, no matter where you are, we can meet, we can talk, we can share about actual situations. You see, I can give an example. You know, I have one of my sisters who is in the US for the moment I'm speaking, you know, but most of the time we used to talk. Most of the time we used to share, you know, about families, about other stuff, you see. We are together, though we are very far from one another, but we are so close, you know. That is a big advantage of the social media, you see. Connectivity. We are together, though we are far.
Okay, so I'm gathering again the question when you were talking about connectivity. So today you can make a relationship with whomever, the people, the person that you don't know. The person can be also a devil, you don't know him. But when you're talking about connectivities, do you think that is better?
You know, I'm seeing things in a good way. You know, I'm objective.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm not subjective. I think this situation is a good when I talk about an activity. I mean, people I know, you know, people,
yeah.
even though I don't know you, but the time we are together, the time we continue talking, maybe I will understand after if you are a good person or a bad person. And then I will have time to make a decision about how to break up the relationship or how to continue the relationship.
Okay, so do you have a word to say?
Yes, I would like to fix the point. Because as you said, it said that social media is about be connected, stay together, build networks. That's good. But he said it is not subjective, it is objective. So God has your objective. Yeah. So let's try to face the problem. Here in Bandundu, in DRC, our country, okay, so many people are addicted in social network. Yeah, social network, social media bring provoke addiction. A more powerful addiction than cigarettes, than alcohol, because there are people who once they are not connected a day, they feel like sick, they feel like, you know, so bad, okay, so terrible. They find themselves obliged to be connected in social networks. And that's not good. That's what we call addiction. And that addiction, as you use it abusively, okay, it also provoke mental illness. There are people today who have lost their self-confidence because they see others publishing their wealth, their cars, their good clothes, you see, that showing that their life is perfect. And when people are watching that, especially youth or teenagers, they feel like they are unfortunate. Yeah, like they have no change. They don't represent anything. You see, that it brings also loneliness. You see, someone is now like, that's not good. That's not good for health. It's not good for education. It's not good for life. Okay? To pick up some money, get some advantages from other people via social networks. Someone that you don't know, I'm a stranger, you talk to me, I am I have a bad mindset. Okay? I'm aiming to twist you, I'm aiming to steal you. I will make myself a good person. I will talk to you as if I were a responsible. Mm-hmm. But after the time you see that I've already stolen you. Okay, it's really very late because you try to take someone that you don't know, someone that you never meet. You see? That's why I said that social media are not good. For our children, for our generation, okay? Good, but not good enough. We have to take social media with a pinch of salt.
So I think that apart from what you said, there are also other things to add, so I will come back to this soon. So my brother, you can have a word, okay? So you're listening to what they say, okay? What they say. So what can you add? Going firstly to the advantage. You hear what my brother say that social network and hard to be connected or with connectivities. What can you add about?
Yeah, I found it that he correct, you know. When he's talking about social network help us to be connected around the world, you know. That could be the idea, you know. So when because when I'm talking about it, I know that myself I try to use social network and I'm connected with brother in which we've called, you know. We were separated makes a long time ago, you know. So when I found them by using social network, so it is so important. So we talk with brother who are living in South Africa, United States of America, you know. So it's very, very important. This is one of the advantages of social network. So what was the point of view? When he's talking about disadvantages of social networks, I'm also with him. You know, I have to be as it changed in the middle of a village. So what Master Lee is talking about, it's not good, and it's good but not good enough. Yes, you know, a social network here in Bandundu, situation here in Bandundu, like people are using it, you know, teenager, you know, young. So they are using it abusively, you know. So it is not a good way to use it. So because I try to use Facebook, sometimes WhatsApp, I see how people, how young, as a publishing thing. So I don't know. I don't know how to explain, you know. So they are doing theater, you know. Like a theater, they are publishing things like this for making people laughing. So they are publishing photos with other people. You know, so they are using it just for showing to others that we got it in life, and so something like this, you know. So I found advantages and disadvantages which was given by Master Lee and Mr. Shakes. So important, you know. So
yeah, Master D's, I think you were talking about cyberbullying, so can you
I say you have to know that in thanks to social networks, there are many people who are victims of what they call cyberbullying. Cyberbullying, it is the way, what you call in French, harcèlement. Okay, but harcèlement throughout social media. Okay, and there is also another thing. I was explaining, I said, you can find a girl or a boy who says, discovers a beautiful lady, a beautiful girl. Okay? You try to make a relationship. Maybe he gets the number of the girl without her permission, without having the green on the girl. Okay? Then begin to send her messages, texts, because he's connected. Only because he's connected, his capacity of sending messages or writing, sending voices. Now we try to bury that. So that's even a crime in our laws, okay? Especially celebrities, you know, celebrities, people like our political leaders, yeah? They are also victims of cyberbullying. Everyone is sending them messages, insulting them sometimes, because they don't appreciate X thing or Y thing. See, that's even a crime. It is provoked by the social media. Another thing is also misleading information. Just because you are connected, you have your smartphone, your computer, you are connected through social media, social networks, Facebook, WhatsApp, you have the capacity to be able to everybody. Has the ability of sending messages, of sending, publishing information. So most of the time, what people do is to publish fake news of misleading information. And thus misleading information can lead even to trouble in the society, okay? Can lead to bad attitude, fear, okay, hate. Other people are publishing tribalist messages. You know, Balubas, we hate Balubas, we hate Fayulu brothers, people from Bandundu. Yeah, you see, through the social network.
Okay, so
thank you. Too many advantages.
Thanks very much, Master Dean. Let me return back here from you, my brother. You've listened to what Master Dean said about these advantages. What can you say? What can you argue against the advantage of social network?
Master Dean is right. You know, he's right to say that from his point of view, you know, there are many advantages. But I don't think so, because I'm sustaining the advantages of social media. I think today, as he's talking about news, fake news, or things like that. I think today we can also good news from the social media.
But most of them are
not most of them. That's most of them. I can also say that most of the news on social media are true. You know,
Sure? Are you sure
yes.
what you are?
Most, I said, most. If I said most, it means that there is a few.
Why?
There is some, just a few part of information that is not true. I think people can get informed from the social media. Can have true. You know, televisions today, they don't like to tell the truth. You know, but if I see something happening right now, I can pull out my camera, take a picture or record a video, and share it on social media, and people can see the truth. You know, about what happened.
George Production.
I can give you an example. You know the George
Floyd. Yeah.
George Floyd. USA.
Yeah.
Who died a few months later. Mm-hmm. Who told people the truth about his death? It was someone who just pulled out his camera and take a video. Mm-hmm. That was the truth. And you know what happened after Floyd's death?
You see,
that is the truth. You know, social media is helping people to get true information. If it was according to the police, they should not publish that video. Mm-hmm. According to social media, by means of social media, we have the truth, and now black people can march everywhere. They can cry and say that we are against police officers. We are against the way people are treating black people, you know. That is the truth. So, apart from the true information on social media, we also have our exchange of ideas, you know. From social media, we can exchange our ideas. It is contributing to the education, because today you can learn from the social media. You know, there are online lessons. Mm-hmm. People are teaching and people are learning.
Master is an example.
Master T is a big example of the advantage of social media.
Yeah.
You know, he has classes, English classes on WhatsApp, you know, and he's got many people following him. He's got many students on WhatsApp, you know. So I think social media is now helping people in this lockdown moment. You know, everyone is at home. There is no school, you know, but people can keep on learning though they are at home, you know. They don't go to university, but they've got lessons, they've got people teaching them, and they are working on their education.
Okay guys, so thank you very much. We're running around the time. I think that today we can't be at the end of that topic, even if next time we will be talking about this. So my brother, you hear or you listen what that guy said about, he gave an example as Master D is doing to a true social network. So he's good giving causes, okay, by WhatsApp. But do you think that idea is good? Because I can also make a remark. Okay, everybody doesn't read what is selling by WhatsApp.
So you know what Master D is doing in social network. So it helps people, you know. So it is good. His idea. So I don't find it. I don't find it like a bad idea, because it's helping people. By teaching them, by helping them, because we, the government, okay, and I say our response, I'm talking about what Muyembe is doing, our team response, yes, the team response sent to the people to stay at home, okay, and to refuse to see and run 20 people, you know, to be together. So by using a social network, Mostly is earning money, you know. So this is an advantages of using social network. So about what Mr. Shakespeare said, what we are saying now about George Floyd action, yes, George Floyd action. So it was a true action, you know. He So, I don't share this some idea. What we see that there are most of information in social networks are true. No, I'm not with you. Because many people, if by using social networks, they are sharing what happened in their mind. You know, so you will be with me right now, you know. When people are publishing things, you know, so they are publishing things like for making us laughing. Yeah. I will tell you that the truth. So we found it every time, you know, internet man by internet. You know?
And misunderstanding.
Yeah.
They are sharing their misunderstanding, the entertainment, and fake news.
Something like this. So that's why I said, I don't refuse no idea, but I don't agree when you are saying that most of information in, also most news in social networks are true. It were hard not when I read it.
Yeah. Okay, so the last day, I think you have much thing to say, but we don't have a lot of time. Okay? So,
I'll sum up. I'll sum up my address of today by inviting people to be responsible, to know what they are doing again through social network, because as I say, there are more disadvantages than advantages again given by Mr. Shakes and supported by Mr. Harstoni. There are advantages, but more disadvantages. There are also privacy issues. Today, many companies, when they want to hire you, okay, they check your Facebook account, they know the content you publish, your hobbies, and those information of your privacy, of your private life, can help them to hire you or not. Okay, it can cause your firing from the company. You understand this? There are so many problems, so many risks. So people, users of the social networks, have to be careful with what they are doing. Don't use it a lot, use it later. Okay? Let's use social networks, Facebook, WhatsApp, and so on. Let's use them later, but not much. That's what I can say for the time.
Okay, so thank you very much. I think we already have for today, but next time I think we have to keep on with the topic because it's so large. Okay, so what can be your last word, Mr. Chicks?
Thank you so much, man, for the work. We are at the end of our show. I just want to let all the people who are watching us right now that social media as anything that can have an advantage and a disadvantage, it depends on the usage of the user.
Okay.
You know, so you as a user of social media, you should know what to take from the social media and what to take off from the social media. You see, so we just have to see much more, to turn our first much more to the advantages than to disadvantages. Know what you publish. Also, man who are reading what you publish, you know. Be true, be yourself.
That's a good point.
You see, you just have to know that there is no two people in the world who are just like, who are just like,
what
who are the same. You see, you are special, you know. Be the way you are.
Be the way you are.
Be the way you are. You are so special. There is nobody else like you.
So. Okay, so thanks, my brother, for your part of you. I think you have a few words, okay? Just a few words about everything that we don't hear, because we have to be separated from you.
Okay, so, dear ladies and gentlemen, you know, time is money, as American, as American says. We've got to work on our time. We can't spend time by using Facebook, social network like this. So my piece of advice that I can give you now, right now, is to have your own timetable. So
that's good.
You have to have your own timetable. You've got time to
There's time to use Facebook.
So thank you, dear viewers. I think we are at the end of that Broadcast English Club show. It was a pleasure for me to present you that broadcast today. I say thank you to my brother Lolita Mufu and Alan Sindani. So I think that's next time. We will be seen at the same broadcasting. Thank you, Mama Maggie Mundeli, because we are here at that good place, Mama Maggie Hotel, at downtown. Okay, so thank you very much. I think we will be seen next time. See you next and keep in touch. So thank you, my brothers. I think we can.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey.